So we will continue with the English grammar chapter, primary auxiliaries and modals. We have done till exercise D yesterday.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
So yes, ma'am.
Let's move on then. Now, if we want to grant some offer, means if I'm offering to do something for you, then there are some ways in which we can grant offer, means we can make an offer. Like, I'll help you with that sum. Shall I help you with that sum? Can I help you with that sum? Could I help you? Or would you like me to help you with that sum? Now, that is if you are offering help to someone. Alright, you want to help someone and you want to offer that help, then these are the ways in which we can offer help to other people. Okay, so let's try to do this exercise E. Complete the sentences with shall I or I will, I'll and a verb from the box. First one, it's screwed on really tightly. So, first one I'll let you know. Shall I unscrew it for you? Shall I unscrew it for you? Shall I unscrew it for you? Okay, second. I can't complete all this homework.
Ma'am, can I tell?
Ma'am,
I'll help you with your homework.
Okay. I can't complete all this homework. So, I'll help you with it. I'll help you.
Ma'am, please tell the page number.
Page number 19. I'll help you with it. Next, I am really very hungry. Yes, Aram.
Ma'am, please repeat the
second. Ma'am, shall I make some food?
Should I?
Ma'am, can I tell Hamad?
Ma'am, I'll make some food for you.
Yes, Hamad, what do you want to tell?
Shall I make something for you?
Okay, I am really very hungry. So you can also say, shall I make you something to eat? Or you can also tell what you want to make. So you can also say, shall I make you a quick sandwich? For example, shall I make you a quick sandwich? Means very fast. Shall I make you something? So shall I make you a quick sandwich? Shall I make you a quick sandwich?
Ma'am, can you repeat the second one?
I'll help you with it. This suitcase is very heavy.
The answer is that shall I carry the heavy suitcase?
Yes, anyone else?
Ma'am, Krishna.
Yes, Krishna.
Ma'am, may I tell you,
I will carry it for you.
Okay, I'll carry it for you. This suitcase.
Ma'am, can I carry it for you?
Okay.
Ma'am, can I carry it?
Ma'am, may I tell?
Yes, Aram.
Ma'am, shall I help you to carry this suitcase?
Or just just make words here and there. I'll help you with that suitcase. I'll help you with that suitcase. This suitcase is very heavy. I'll help you with that suitcase. Obviously, you can make some other sentence also. But this is means what I am letting you know. Obviously, this is not the only thing that can be correct. There can be other correct answers also. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Like you
ma'am,
said,
please repeat.
Shall I carry it with carry it for you? So even that is not wrong. When you say, shall I carry it for you? Even that is not wrong. That is also correct. And this
ma'am.
Is also correct. I'll help you with that suitcase.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, beta.
Ma'am, can I carry it for you? Be also correct.
Beta, can I carry it for you? Okay, yes, why not? Because we just now saw that we can use all these words when we want to make an offer of help. So you can use shall, I'll, can, could, would. All right, we can use all of these. Next, it's really warm in here.
Ma'am, shall I switch on the fan for you?
Shall I switch on the fan or shall I turn on the fan? Switch on the fan, I think, is much better. Shall I switch on the fan?
Ma'am, may I?
What, Peta?
Ma'am, may I switch on the fan for you?
No, not may I.
Can I?
We don't use may when we offer help.
Okay, ma'am.
Shall I switch on the fan? Okay, next. Last one here. I don't have the energy to go and open the door.
Ma'am, can I tell Hamad?
Ma'am, may I tell Iram?
Yes, Zaim. Zaimuddin, right?
Ma'am, yes. Shall I open the door for you?
Shall I open the door? Okay. I don't have the energy to go and open the door. So means the person is very tired, he cannot go and open the door. So you can say, shall I open the door? That is correct. Anyone else? Shall I open the door is correct.
Ma'am, I'll open the door whenever you say.
Okay, no, not whenever you say, I'll open the door. That is also correct. You could either write, I'll open the door.
Ma'am, can I open the door?
Or, shall I open the door? Alright, let's move on.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, beta.
Ma'am, in these types of sentences, do we have to mark the question mark?
Yes, if it is a question, then you need to put a question mark. Like if you write, shall I open the door? Then obviously you need to put the question mark. But if you say, I'll open the door, then there's no need. So depending on the type of sentence you make, you have to put the correct punctuation also. Okay, so when you want to take any suggestion or make any suggestion, then this is how we can do it. If you are taking a suggestion or if you are making a suggestion, shall we go to Paris this autumn? Why don't we go to Paris this autumn? How about going to Paris this autumn? We could go to Paris this autumn. So if you want to make a suggestion, alright, then if you want to make a suggestion or if you are taking suggestion from someone, then we can do this likewise. We can use these words, shall we, why don't we, how about, we could. So all this could be used to make a suggestion or to take in a suggestion. We have exercise related to it. Okay. Exercise F. Complete the sentences with the correct form of the verbs given in the bracket. It's raining so hard. What about dash? In the bracket you have stay in for dinner today instead of going out. What about?
Ma'am, can I tell Daniel?
Yes, sir. Ma'am, Fahad, it's raining so hard. What about we could stay in for dinner instead of going out?
Beta, this exercise, you have to use the correct form. So.
Ma'am, can I tell?
You can also give only the correct form of the verb here. What about? Now, if you write what about, all that would be a wrong sentence. So, what about staying in? What about staying in? So, first is staying. Second, Deepthi, yes, that's a good idea. Shall
Ma'am, order.
Please read the first one.
Staying. What about staying in for dinner? Instead of going out.
Beta. Your voice is echoing.
Beta, it is not echoing.
Ma'am, because of Anjanya
Rekhtasogi. Mic is muted. That is why.
Anjanya, ma'am, Anjanya.
Yes, I know. So it was coming back.
Now, ma'am, please repeat the first.
Yes, now it is okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Mute only when you want to answer, then unmute and very quickly mute them back again. First is staying. What about staying in? STAYING, in for dinner today instead of going out. Second one. Yes, that's a good idea. Shall we dash? Some sandwiches from
Ma'am, order.
Okay, order.
Ma'am, may I tell them?
Shall we order? Okay, see. Fahad, we dash also dash some noodles at home.
Ma'am, can I tell Hamad?
Yes, Hamad.
Ma'am, we could also make some noodles at home.
Okay, you can use can also. We can make some noodles.
Yes, ma'am, can also.
Yes. So, we can make some noodles at home.
Ma'am, can we use might?
What, beta?
Ma'am, can we use might?
Use can. That's right.
Ma'am, please.
Yes.
Ma'am, please repeat second one.
Second is order. Okay, we move on. Next page, page number 20. That's right. In any case, we make better noodles than anybody around here. How about dash? Chop the vegetables for the dish while I boil the noodles.
Ma'am, can I tell you?
That's
right. In any case, we make better noodles than anybody around here. How about chopping the vegetables for the dish while I boil the noodles?
Okay, correct. Chopping. So, blank E, chopping. Fahad, and what about dash? Bracket, you have make some soup to go with it.
Ma'am, the answer is, I'm making some soup.
And what about making some soup to go with it? why don't we also dash some chicken as a side dish? Yes, Ram.
Ma'am, can
ma'am, Deepthi, why don't we also stir fry some chicken as a side dish?
All right, stir fry some chicken as a side dish. So Fahad says yes, that's a great idea. Okay, let's move on. Now, to express restriction for something on somebody, if you want to put a restriction, means which a person is not allowed to do. When you want to tell something that you can't do this, you express a restriction for that. So we can write the sentences like, you mustn't go near the fire, means must not. So you mustn't go near the fire. Then we can't go in shabby clothes, or you aren't allowed to talk inside the library. So you when you want to tell about the restrictions on something, all right, restrictions, then you can use these words. Okay, now another exercise we have, take the correct sentences. For the incorrect ones, identify the extra word and write it in the space given. So you know, if there is any correct sentence, there is nothing wrong, so you tick the correct sentence. If now for the incorrect sentences, you have to identify that which word is extra, which we don't require in the sentence, and then you need to write that word in the blanks, blank spaces which are given. So the first sentence, I have to go to work early tomorrow.
Correct.
Yes. Correct.
Yes. Correct.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Now, second, you don't have to go out in the rain without an umbrella.
You don't have to go out.
Okay, now if we combine this particular exercise with what we did just now, so what wrong would be here? I'll tell you what is wrong here, and then what would be the correct thing here. You don't have got to go out in the rain without an umbrella, you will get drenched. You are we allowed?
Ma'am, in this sentence, don't have, do it wrong.
Yes.
Ma'am, it should be, you mustn't go out in the rain.
Yes, that is the correct thing. Now, in this sentence, what is incorrect? Don't have got to is incorrect. And what should be the correct thing in place of that?
Ma'am, mustn't means must not.
MUSTN apostrophe T. MUSTN apostrophe T. So the wrong is don't have got to, and in place of that you write mustn't. Next, are we allowed come in here at this hour?
Ma'am, come is longer.
Yes, who will tell this?
Can I tell, Karthik?
Yes, Karthik, tell.
Ma'am, come is incorrect.
What is incorrect?
Ma'am, come in.
Okay, the incorrect is allowed come in. Allowed come in. Correct should be?
Allowed to enter.
Allowed to come in. You just need to add to also there. So allowed come in is wrong. Allowed, are we allowed to come in?
Can't we write allowed to enter here?
enter, then you need to change the rest of the sentence also. Enter.
Ma'am, in also, correct.
In also, then enter in here. So allow to come. Allowed to come in. Okay. Then next, you don't need to worry about what you will wear for the party on tomorrow. I have got something for you.
Ma'am, may I tell?
Can I tell, Ma'am Myra?
Yes, Myra, tell.
Ma'am,
you do not need to worry about what you will wear for the party on tomorrow. I have got something for you. Ma'am, not will be not there. Ma'am, on will be not there.
Okay, so just the word party on tomorrow, it should not be party on tomorrow. It should be party tomorrow. Okay?
Tomorrow.
Yes. So it should not be party on tomorrow. It should be party tomorrow. The last here. I can't to see that far in the distance.
Ma'am, can I tell you much?
Ma'am,
Ma'am, two will be not there. I can't see that far in the distance.
Okay. Can't to see is wrong. Can't see. So, should not be there. Two should not be there.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, in this sentence, it could be also written as I can't able to see that far in the distance.
I can't.
I'm able to see.
I am not able to see.
That is not correct sentence.
Ma'am, it will be I am not.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Either can't see or I am not able to see. Alright, so this completes exercise G. Let's move on. We still have some time. Now, if we want to give advice to someone, then we use should, ought to, had better when we want to give advice to someone. Like, you ought to see a doctor, you should see a doctor, you had better see a doctor. With had better, basically what we do, we warn somebody. When we use had better, so what we want to say, you had better do that. Otherwise means, though we don't write everything, but it comes with a warning that it is better that you do this thing, otherwise something bad will happen, something will happen. So we use had better with a warning. Like when we want to warn someone, then we use had better. Okay? Otherwise, giving advice, you can use ought to or should. Then, now if we want to show our criticism that what someone did was wrong according to us, and if we want to show our criticism for that, then we use should have been. That you should have been more cautious about your health. You should have been more cautious. Alright. So should have been. That is what we use. Okay. I think we still have time to complete this next exercise. Let's try to finish this. Exercise H. Complete the sentences with should or shouldn't, ought or oughtn't. Okay. Exercise H. The doctor says that you...
Ma'am, may I tell Krishna? The doctor says that you should drink at least 12 glasses of water every day.
Alright. Okay. Now, you know, we can use should, but should and ought to. You can say they are like interchangeable. You can use both. The doctor says that you ought to drink at least. You could also say the doctor says that you should. So even should is correct and ought to is also correct. Okay, so the doctor says that you should drink at least 12 glasses of water every day. She also says that you...
Can I tell something?
Prakhar?
Yes, Prakhar.
You ought.
Yes, ma'am.
The answer is she ought. Is that you shouldn't drink adulterated drinks or eat junk food. You have grown obese and you will continue to grow.
So she also says that you shouldn't, means you should not, drink I rarely eat drinks or eat junk food. You have grown obese and you will continue to grow more obese if you don't change your lifestyle immediately. You, yes, dash, stay away.
Ma'am, you shouldn't stay awake till late in the night.
You shouldn't stay awake, or you ought not to stay awake. So you can use even oughtn't to. Alright? You shouldn't stay awake. You can write that also. Or you can also write you oughtn't to. Ought not to. You ought not to stay awake till. I think shouldn't is much better. We should go with shouldn't.
Yes, ma'am. Shouldn't is much better.
You shouldn't stay awake till late in the night, nor.
Ma'am, can I tell Ammat?
Krishna. Ma'am, can I tell Krishna?
Kartik. Ma'am, Kartik.
Yes, no, Ammat.
Can I tell?
Nor shouldn't you sleep until late in the day.
Nor shouldn't you. Nor is already there.
Ma'am should.
Yes, nor should you sleep until late in the day. You. Last one.
Ma'am, get an Ahmad.
Ma'am,
you ought to adopt healthy timings and live by them.
Okay, you ought to adopt healthy timings.
Ma'am, can you should be there? You should.
You should? Yes, beta, you can use that also. No problem.
Okay.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, I told you that ma'am, should please. And ought to are interchangeable here. Yes.
Ma'am, please repeat second line.
Second one. Ma'am, second is shouldn't.
Yes, ma'am.
She also says that you shouldn't.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Written all of you?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so that is all the time we have for today. So for today, we will stop here.
Thank you, ma'am.